Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. I receive a lot of comments to make a project which can be controlled both by Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Now with this IoT project, you can control all these relays both from the Blynk IoT app and also with the Bluetooth app at the same time. And here you can see I have just used a ESP32 and a relay module to make this complete project. I have not used any external Bluetooth device. And if there is no Wi-Fi, here you can see the blue LED is not glowing, so it is not connected with the Wi-Fi. So I can only control the appliances with the IR remote, manual switch and also with the Bluetooth app. Now if the Wi-Fi is available, the blue LED will automatically turn on. So now I can able to control the appliances with the Blynk. And I can also monitor the real-time feedback on the Blynk IoT app. And I have also used preference library. Let me turn on the first relay. If I turn off the complete supply, the ESP32 can also remember the previous states of the relay. If I turn on the supply again, after a certain time, the first relay will automatically turn on. So this is a very useful IoT project. During the video, I have explained all the steps. So after watching the complete video, anyone can make this project. So without any further delay, let's get started. This video is sponsored by Altium, which is a world-class PCB designer software trusted by the most of the big electronic companies. The user interface is so simple, you can easily design any complex PCBs in Altium. Now Altium came up with an amazing product called Altium 365. Altium 365 is an electronic product design platform that unites PCB design, MCAD, data management and teamwork. With Altium 365, you can not only design PCBs, but you can also share your projects to your teammates for review. It also provides automatic backup, centralized cloud storage and a lot more. And along with all this, they do have a very useful search engine just for electronic components called as Octopart. Using Octopart, you can search for any electronic components, compare the price and availability around the globe. Apart from that, you can also check the datasheet. Altium provides everything to make your production task a lot easier. And now you can download the free trial version of the Altium PCB Designer software from the description and use all these services in your next PCB design. In the circuit, I have given the 5V DC supply and here I have used active low relay module. So the relay will turn on for the low signal in the control pin. As you can see, you can make the circuit without using any PCB, but just to make the circuit compact, I have designed these PCBs for this project. You can download the GAWA file from the video description. Let me connect the ESP32 on this PCB and here I have to connect the IR receiver. Now let me connect it with the laptop. Now we will quickly configure the Blynk IoT platform. First, I will create a template. So let me click here to go to templates, then click on new templates, give a name. I am giving smart home. In the hardware, I have selected ESP32, connection type will be Wi-Fi. Now click on done. Now I will go to data stream, click on new data stream, select virtual pin. Here I will give the name switch 1. You can give any name. In the pin, I will select V1. Data type will be integer, then minimum value will be 0, maximum value will be 1, then I will click on create. In a similar way, I will create another 3 data streams using V2, V3, V4. Here you can see I have created total 4 data streams for 4 relays. Now if you want, you can also define automation in Blynk IoT. Now let me save this template. After that, I have to add device, so I will click here, then click on new device. Select from template. Now I have to select the template and click on create. Let me go to device info. This is the source code for this project. You can download the code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article. You can find a link in the description. Then you can download the code from these buttons. After downloading, open the sketch with Arduino IDE. For this project, you have to install the latest ESP32 board and these are the required libraries for this project. Now first, we will enter the Blynk details. So let me go to Blynk account and I will click here to copy all these details. Then here I will paste it. Then here I have to enter the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password.
Then here you have to enter the hex code for the IR remotes. Please refer my previous tutorial on how to get the hex code from IR remote. Then here you can see these are the GPIO details for the relay and switches. Now let me go to void setup. In the setup, I'm calling this function to start the Bluetooth, and here I have given the name for the Bluetooth. You can give any name. Now let me go to void loop, and here I'm calling this function to control the relay with Bluetooth. Let me go to the Bluetooth control function. So here we are checking if any data available from the Bluetooth. Then if you receive capital A, then we are turning on the first relay. If you receive small a, then we are turning off the first relay. In this manner, we are controlling the relay by comparing the data received from the Bluetooth. Now to upload this code, I will go to tools, then select the board ESP dev module. In the partition scheme, I have selected huge app 3MB. This is important. You have to select this partition scheme only. Then select the proper port, then hit the upload button.
Now here you can see this blue LED is glowing, which indicates now it is connected with the Blynk server. So let me configure the Blynk IoT app. So this is our device. Let me tap on it. Now I will tap on the setting icon, then tap on the plus icon, then add 4 button widget to control 4 relay. After that, I will tap on the first button widget. Then here I will select the data stream V1 and then select the mode switch. Now I will exit from the widget. In a similar way, I will configure another 3 button widget using V2, V3 and V4. And always the mode will be switch. Now I will exit from the setting mode. Now I will quickly install the Bluetooth app, which I have developed in the MIT App Inventor. You can download the APK file from the video description. Now let me go to my files, then go to APK. This is the app version 1. Let me tap here to install it. Now while installing, you may get some warning as I have not submitted this app in the Google Play Store. Now let me open this app. Now using this app, you can control total 8 relay, but here we are using 4 relay, so we will use first 4 button. Now to connect the ESP32 with this app, first we have to turn on the Bluetooth, then we have to pair the ESP32. So let me tap on more, and under the available device, you can see ESP32_BT. This name we have given in the code. So let me tap here to pair it. Now tap on pair. After pairing, let me go to the app. Now I will tap on this button, tap to connect. Then from this list, I will select ESP32_BT. So now here you can see it is showing connected. So let me control the relays from this Bluetooth app. I can use this button to turn off all the relay. Now if you are not able to get the ESP32_BT in this list, then you have to give some permission to this app. For that, go to setting, then go to apps, then app management. From this list, select the Bluetooth switch, then go to permission, and here you have to give the permission nearby devices, so this app can search nearby Bluetooth device. After giving this permission, the app can detect the ESP32, and then you can connect it and control the appliances from the Bluetooth. So if you find this video helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. You can also join our Telegram channel Tech Study Cell and follow us on Instagram. You can find a link in the description. For more such videos, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.